The advanced software includes an analysis tool that allows you to generate data sets that represent multiple years of data that have been averaged together. Not only will the software combine and average the data, but you also have the ability to normalize the information, which allows you to compare data that is not the same, such as yield information that includes multiple crop types. In this tutorial, you will learn how to create and save a multi-year averages dataset and run this analysis for a single field or across multiple fields. To begin, go to the Analysis menu and choose Analysis Wizard, or click on the Analysis Wizard icon in the main toolbar. The Select Analysis Type to Run window will now open. All of the analysis function types are displayed on the left-hand side of the screen. Click the Multi-Year Averages Analysis button. You will now be able to add a new analysis or edit any existing analyses that were previously created. We will click on the Add button to build a new analysis. The following screen will allow you to enter a name or description for the new analysis. Input a name that will allow you to easily determine what the analysis includes, as these two pieces of information will be displayed on the main Analysis Wizard screen. After inputting the name and description, click Next. The Select Data Filters dialog will now open. This screen allows you to select the management items that you wish to have included in your analysis. Select the grower, farm, and field that you wish to run the analysis for, and then select the years to include and the operation to base the new data set off of. Click Next after the desired management items have been selected. The Edit Data Filter Results dialog will now be displayed, where you can select and delete any data sets that you do not want to be included in the new average data set. Click Next. The Aggregate Options window will now open. This tool allows you to select the attributes that you want to generate a multi-year average data set for. So, if you wanted a resulting data set that displayed the average yield from the previous 3 years, you would want to select Estimated Volume Dry and Add to the Selected Attributes window on the right-hand side of the screen. You can also choose to normalize the selected attribute, either against the data mean or on a 0 to 100% scale. Normalizing allows you to compare data that is not the same in a logical manner. In this example, because we are including harvest information that includes both corn and soybean data, we will want to normalize so that the results accurately represent the yield information across all 3 years. Click Next after adding over all desired attributes. Next, the Grid Options dialog will open. This screen can be used to modify the grid and interpolation settings that will be used in the newly created data set. Click Finish after making any desired changes. The multi-year averages analysis has now been created and saved. You can now choose to run this analysis for a single field or across multiple fields. In this example, we will run our analysis for a single field. The Select Data Filter screen will open, and you will be asked to define what data sets to use. By default, the data sets that you defined while creating the analysis will be selected. Click Next after making any necessary changes. The Data Filters Results screen will allow you to remove any unwanted data sets from being included in the analysis results. Click the Finish button and your analysis will begin processing. The Analysis Editor will now open and display the new data set that you created. There are two attributes that will be displayed: the normalized attribute and the coefficient of variation of the attributes you selected to include in the output. Click Save to save this new data set to the management tree. Select the appropriate management items and click Accept. You have now successfully created and saved a multi-year averages data set that can be mapped, printed, and even used as a reference data set in other analysis functions. Please review the other tutorials to learn how to utilize other key features of the software.